Hello learners, I am Radhika, the course coordinator of Computer Science Senior Secondary subject. Today, we will be learning about operators used in C++ programming language. Come, let us learn the operators used in C++ programming language.
Without operators, we cannot perform any operation in the program. In fact, with input-output also, we use the operators, that is extraction operator and put-to operator. So now we'll be learning other operators like arithmetic, relational, logical, unary, assignment operator, conditional operator, and comma operator. We'll be learning all these operators based on the number of operands. Operands means the data on which the operators work. For example, if I want to add two numbers, A plus B. So plus is the operator. By writing the plus sign, I come to know that I have to do the addition operation. So plus is the operator, and A and B is that particular data on which that operation has to be performed. So A and B are operands. So depending on the number of operands that are required by the operator, the classification of operators is into unary and binary. A unary operator requires one operand. The best example that I can give you for this is positive number plus 5 and negative number minus 6. Now, since by default all numbers are considered to be positive, I rarely use plus sign. But if I want to show a negative number, then a minus sign has to be given. So minus here is a unary operator which requires just one operand to signify its sign. So that is a unary operator. Binary operator, on the other hand, requires two operands. Say for example, I want to add two numbers, I require two numbers. Without two numbers, I cannot do the addition operation. So plus is a binary operand. Similarly, other arithmetic operators that we'll be doing, they are also binary operators. Coming over to arithmetic operators, as the name says, these are performing various arithmetic operations, and this is a binary operator, so it requires two operands. The table here shows the five arithmetic operators that are supported by C++. You have plus for addition, minus for subtraction, star for multiplication, a slash for division, and a percentile symbol for modulus. Now here the new thing that you must be coming across is the percentile sign or modulus. The percentile sign gives you the remainder of a division. When we divide two numbers, we get two things. One, the quotient, the other is the remainder. If I want to have the quotient, I use the division operator, that is a slash. If I want to show the remainder, if I want to get the remainder, then I use the percentile. As the example shows, 10 divided by 5 will give you a 2, but 10 modulo 5 will give you a 0, because when I divide 5 by 10, then the remainder is 0. Next, we move on to relational operators. A relational operator is used to test a relation between two operands. Since it is comparing two operands, so it is a binary operator, and it returns a zero if the relation that I am testing is false, and it returns a non-zero when it is true. And the various relational operators are less than equal to, greater than equal to, and not equal to. So A can be less than B, A can be greater than B, and so on. So we test whether A is less than B or whether A is greater than B. If the relation is true, it will return you a non-zero value. If the relation is false, then it returns you a zero value. These are relational operators. The examples are given here. Say for example, I have 5 in X, 4 in Y, and Z in 8. So you can see the statements. The red are in false and the green ones are in true. So depending on the value that X, Y, and Z are having at that particular time, I get the result as false or true of the relation, and then I work accordingly in the program. Next, we move on to logical operators. Now, at one point of time, I might need to compare two or more relations. Say I want to check ki to get admission in class 12th, the student should have secured more than say 8 CGPA and he should have more than 9 in maths. So, I want to check two conditions for one particular job to be done. In such situations, I use the logical operators. A logical operator used to combine one or more relational expression to give one single output. We have three logical operators, the AND operator, the OR operator, and the NOT operator. AND and OR are binary operators, whereas NOT is a unary operator. It requires only one operand. AND operator will return you a false if any one of the expression is false. Say for example, I am comparing A, B and C and the result is true if A is greater than B and A is greater than C. If both are true, only then it will return a true. If any one of them is false, the final result will be false. On the other hand, the OR operator, it returns a true if any one expression is true. Say A is greater than B or A is greater than C, the output is true. And finally, the NOT operator, it reverses the output. Means if the operation is true, it makes it false. If the operation is false, it makes it true. So, these are logical operators. You can see the example here. We have three variables x, y and z with different values. The expression says x greater than y, which is false. The second expression says z less than equal to y, which is true. But since both of them are combined by AND operator, which gives the true only if both are true. Now here x greater than y is false, so the final result will be false. So this is how the logical operators work. Next we move on to assignment operator. Assignment operator we have used in previous examples also. It stores the value that is there on the right hand side of the operator to the left hand side operand. For example, given below 10, the value which is there on the right hand side is being stored in P, which is there on the left hand side. Similarly, the value of P goes to Q, is assigned to Q, which is on the left hand side. This is how the assignment operator works. Then we have increment and decrement operators, which increment or decrement the value by 1. Means if the value is 10, the increment operator will increase by 1, and if the value is 10, the decrement operator will decrease by 1. That means it becomes 9 or 11 as the case may be. Now these operators are used in two forms, that is pre-increment or pre-decrement and post-increment or post-decrement. We have an example to show the concept here. In case of pre-increment, the plus plus sign, now this plus plus sign is one single operator, that is the increment operator. This sign is given before the operand. While in case of post-increment, plus plus sign is given after the operand. In case of pre-increment, first the value will be incremented, then some other operation will be performed. While in case of post-increment, first the other operation will be performed and then the value will be incremented. Like here in the example, the value of x is 10. If I say C out plus plus x, pre-increment, first increment and then the other operation which is displaying in this case will be done. So the output you get is 11. While in case of the other side, it is saying C out x plus plus. So first the value will be displayed. Why? Because the other job is done first. So you will get the output as 10. And similar logic is applied for decrement operations, that means pre and post decrement. Then we have shorthands in C++, where the arithmetic operator is combined with the assignment operator. The examples are given. This shorthands can be used with any of the arithmetic operators. We have the examples with just three operators here, but you can even use division and modulo along with the shorthands. Then we have the conditional operator. This is the only ternary operator used in C++. Why ternary? Because it requires three operands. First operand, as shown in the syntax, is the expression followed by the question mark. Second operand is the expression which is executed if the condition is true. And third operand is the expression which is executed if the condition is false. We have an example here of conditional operator. We have in fact two examples here. In first example, we have two variables A and number. So, number will be assigned with value 5 if A is greater than 12 and 25 otherwise. Now, as you can see in the example that the condition is false, so the number gets the value 25. In another example, good will be displayed if A is less than equal to 10 and okay will be displayed if it is not less than equal to 10. Now here, since the condition is true, so good will be displayed. So a conditional operator works on the condition. It is the output is given according to the condition whether it is true or false. Next we have the size of operator. It is used to find out how many bytes are being consumed by a variable or a data type. It is used just like that as it is written, size of without any space. If I say size of char, since char takes 1 byte, so it's one, it returns 1. If I say size of int, it returns 2. If I say float or any variable name, it returns a 4. Finally, we have done various type of operators. Now, if we use multiple operators in a single expression, then what is the order in which different operators will be executed? The table shows the highest to lowest precedence. In maths, you have BODMAS. In computers, in C++ programming, you have precedence rules that have to be followed. You have to be very careful while evaluating an expression that these precedence rules are followed.
I hope you must have found this video very interesting. Here you have learnt about arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, unary operator, assignment operator, conditional operator and size of operator. I hope this was a great learning experience for you. Now we can start write a simple and small program in C++. Compile and run your program. Check for any errors. If there is any error, rectify it and try to get the desired output. In the coming videos, we will be learning about general concept of object-oriented programming, control statements, functions, arrays, classes and objects, inheritance, pointer and files. So, let us meet in the next video. Till then, it's bye from Radhika. Thank you.